Hey guys, Puneet here from Coach. In today's video, we are going to be studying the chords derived from the harmonic minor scale. In the previous two videos, we have covered the chords derived from the major scale and the natural minor scale. So, before we get into the lesson, I would request you to also check out my other guitar lessons. I'm providing a link in the description. Do check it out. If you like what you see, please do like, share and subscribe. Also, if you wish to support me and you feel I'm helping you in your guitar journey, please do download or stream my original songs. I'm providing the link again in the description. It will really matter a great deal to me if you give me your feedback and support me. So coming to the harmonic minor scale, as we discussed, what is the need for the harmonic minor scale is mainly that the 5-to-1 resolution, which happens in a major scale, is not happening in a minor scale because we don't have a dominant seventh in that place. So this is corrected by the harmonic minor scale, and a harmonic minor scale is exactly the same as a natural minor scale, but there is a raised or a sharp seventh note. So what that means is, in an A minor scale, the normal notes of the natural A minor scale are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. So what happens in a harmonic minor scale is you sharp the seventh note. In the A minor scale, the A minor natural scale, we have G as a seventh note. So what we are going to do is we are going to sharpen it. That is, we are going to make G as G sharp or an A flat. So it will sound like this. So I hope you can make out that it sounds much more tense and has got much more flavor as compared to a natural minor scale, and this is known as the harmonic minor scale. And now when we go to generate chords from this, again the chords will be almost same as that of the natural minor scale, but all the chords containing the note G will now contain the note G sharp, right? So starting with the triads, that is the three note chords, we will get, we have A minor as the first chord, which is A, C, E. We have no G note over here, so it will remain the same. Then going to B diminished. The notes here are B, D, F. Again, no change because there is no G note. Then coming to the third chord, it will be a C major. Now this has C, E and G. So G will become G sharp. So the chord will become C, E, G sharp, C, which is also known as an augmented C, augmented triad. We will be discussing augmented chords separately as an entire series in itself because it is a very vast and a little complicated topic, but I will be breaking it down step by step. So for now, just know that this augmented chord comes from your harmonic minor scale, but we will not be focusing on this chord in this particular series. This is the C augmented. Then the next chord is a D minor. This is D, F and A. And again, there's no G note, so it remains the same. Then the next chord is an E minor. This has E, B and G. So again, G becomes a G sharp. So E minor becomes an E major. So this is the main new chord that you get from the harmonic minor scale, the E major. Then going to F major. F major has got F, A and C notes, which again has no G. So it remains as F major. Then the next chord, which was G major, now we don't have a G in the harmonic minor, so we'll use a G sharp. So the triad will become G sharp, B and D, which is also known as a G sharp diminished triad, right? Which is the same as the B diminished triad, the same thing. So this is what is a diminished triad. Again, diminished chords and half diminished chords I will be teaching in a lot of detail as a separate course, just like augmented chords. So we will not be focusing on these chords for now. So you should know that this comes from the harmonic minor scale. So G sharp. So G sharp diminished, and then back to A minor, the root chord. So quickly, the chords are in the harmonic minor are A minor, B diminished, C augmented, D minor, then E major, F major, then we have the G diminished, and back to the A minor. These are the triads or the diatonic triads to A harmonic minor scale. Now, extending the concept, we'll go to four note chords. Again, we do the same thing. So the first chord was A minor 7. Now this has A, C, E and G. So we can't use G here. So we'll add a G sharp instead. So the chord that is formed from this is a very particular chord, very peculiar chord, called as a A minor major 7. So this is a very tense, very beautiful chord, and it's very commonly used in background music, especially in James Bond movies. And it's usually like either an opening chord or a concluding chord. And again, I'm going to be having a separate video in this series itself for a minor major 7 chord. But it's not very common to use this in pop music or even in jazz. So you should know this for your knowledge, but it's not a very common chord. Then the next chord remains the same, B, D, F and A. There's no G, so it remains as a B half diminished or a B minor 7 flat 5. Then the next chord was a C major 7 in the natural minor scale, which will now become, because we can't use a G note, it will become a chord known as C major 7 with a sharp 5. Because the 5 of the C major 7 is a G note. Now we are using G sharp, so it becomes C major 7 sharp 5. This is not a very commonly used chord, and this belongs to the augmented family of chords. So I will be covering this chord in more detail in the augmented chords course. Then moving on to the next chord is a D minor 7, which has no G note, so it remains as a D minor 7. Then the E minor 7 will become an E 7 because the G becomes a G sharp. So we have this E, B, D and G sharp, or this. Again, we'll be studying these shapes in much more detail as we go ahead. For now, just understand the chord scale formula for a harmonic minor scale. Then F major 7 remains the same, or like this. This is the F major 7. Then the G7 also will change to a G sharp diminished. The notes will be G sharp, B, D and F. So this is how it's played. I will be teaching this to you in much more detail as a separate course for diminished chords. So you should just be aware that this is known as a G full diminished, or also called as a G diminished seventh chord. We'll be coming to the nomenclature. Everything will be discussed in a diminished chord course. So don't worry. Just note that this is called as a diminished seventh chord. And then we come back to the A minor major 7, that is a root chord. So the extended chord scale formula for a harmonic minor scale in A, that is the A harmonic minor scale, is the 1 is the A minor, which becomes an A minor major 7. Then we have the 2 chord, which is a half diminished or a minor 7 flat 5, that is a B minor 7 flat 5. And the chord number 3 becomes a major 7 sharp 5. So this is a major 7 sharp 5, or it's actually, you can just remember it as a C augmented. Then we have the next chord as a D minor 7. So chord number 4 is a minor 7. Then chord number 5 is a 7th or a dominant chord. So here we've got 5 as a dominant chord, that is what we wanted. Then moving on to the next chord, F major 7, which is the 6th chord, is a major 7. Then the 7th chord is a full diminished or a diminished 7th. And then we are back to the root, the minor major 7 chord. So this is the formula for the chords in a harmonic minor scale. So I hope this was helpful and you understood everything that I've taught in this video. So if you have, please move on to the next video.